Tonight we're celebrating an anniversary. It's 10 years this month since the organisation Fixers began appearing on TV, telling their amazing stories. And to mark the occasion, we're looking at how being a fixer can help change lives forever. Naomi Lea from St Asaph was 17 when she started her campaign, and 3 years later she's won several awards. She's one of the most celebrated activists in her field and regularly speaks at conferences. But we'll hear Naomi's latest news in just a moment after a recap of her first broadcast back in October 2015.
About a year ago, I started having severe panic attacks where I couldn't stay in a lesson. I wouldn't be able to be around a lot of people. And I also self-harmed for a while because I felt so isolated. Nobody understood me. We've created a presentation and a film. And today I'm delivering it to a group of Year 9 pupils at my school. It would have helped me if my friends would have recognised that I was struggling. At the time, they didn't realise anything was wrong. They thought everything was fine, when it really wasn't. The message of the film is that the signs are always there, and if you spot them, that you should be supportive to that person and try and help them through it. It doesn't require a professional all the time to help someone, just that they know someone cares about them. I'd be happy if more people were aware of the signs, because there's a lot of people in every school that are going through mental health problems, and it'd be nice if they could be recognised and supported. When I decided to do my fix, mental health wasn't something that was being spoken about in my school. And from the point that my fix was out there, the school started to talk about it a lot more, and I know that when I left that school that those conversations had been opened. So I think it really did help in the school, but also elsewhere and sort of on social media, people were opening up to each other and sharing their stories in response. I think the high point for me was probably getting invited to go to Buckingham Palace because of my campaigning around mental health. I was also given a Diana Award for my Fixers work, as well as being given a Points of Light Award by the Prime Minister for the work that I've done in mental health. Other highlights have been just being able to speak in Parliament, in the Welsh Assembly, and really share my experiences and my story to help create change. Being a Fixer just made my confidence grow so much. So before I became a Fixer, I was struggling really badly with anxiety and panic attacks, and I never thought that I'd be speaking in conferences in front of thousands of people before, but it really allowed me that opportunity. Since my Fixers project, I've gone on to set up a website to provide that information where we can't go into schools, to provide that information online, and also to provide blogs about people's experiences so that young people really have somewhere to go where they can find that information if they're worrying about something. I think the idea of Fixers is just amazing. It really allows young people to be at the heart of the change that they want to make and allows them the opportunity to decide what they want to do and do something about it in a really meaningful way. I'm really excited for the future and what we can go on to achieve as a project, developing our workshops, growing our website and reaching more young people through the work that we do.
Quite an impressive record, isn't it? And you can find out more about the Fixers organisation and what they do by visiting the website at fixers.org.uk.